My name is Paul Wang. I'm professor of cardiovascular medicine and bioengineering by courtesy, and I'm the director of the arrhythmia service at Stanford. Patients with AFib will come through several routes typically. Usually they've seen either their primary care physician or very commonly also a cardiologist. And after the cardiologist has done their initial evaluation, they've determined they need to be treated, they're looking for different options, can they come and see me to discuss what those options might be? And that's the typical kind of environment. Less commonly we'll get someone more direct from the emergency. There'll be patients who actually have, you know, maybe been given the diagnosis and aren't really sure, and they come self-referred. So there's a wide range of patients that end up seeing arrhythmia specialists. The symptoms in atrial fibrillation are really varied. So we'll see patients that, as far as we can tell, they're asymptomatic. So there's those individuals. And they often come to us asking, well, I don't feel bad. Do we need to do anything? And so we have a discussion of the various different both options and considerations. On the other hand, there are people with progressively more symptoms. And so it may be something fairly nonspecific, and that might be fatigue, easily getting tired, sleeping more, those kind of things, or something really related to atrial fibrillation, racing heart rate with associated chest pain or shortness of breath. So that would be your very typical kind of spectrum of symptoms. Once we decide the patient needs treatment for atrial fibrillation, then we decide, well, is their current medical regimen appropriate? That is, typically, are their heart rates controlled? Is it too rapid? Do they have too much and now it's too slow? And so we make that assessment. Occasionally, people might need pacemakers, those kinds of things, but generally, it's medications that we'll use to regulate the heart rate. Sometimes that also includes a procedure called electrocardioversion, where they get a shock to the chest that resets the heart rhythm. So that may be an early step in which they have in terms of their treatment. On the other hand, they may have already had that, and they may come saying, oh, I'm still pretty symptomatic. I've done these initial steps. I've tried these medications. I may have even tried cardioversion. I want to know what else is available. And so then we have the discussion in terms of the special procedure called catheter ablation. And so by catheter ablation, we refer to catheters being tubes that we place inside the body, into the heart. And that's the way in which we go about treating it. And ablation then refers to killing cells that are felt to be responsible for atrial fibrillation. In doing so, we hope to significantly reduce the likelihood that they'll have recurrent atrial fibrillation. The tools we use are relatively simple tools, by and large, and really the major breakthrough was having very specialized tools that were designed specifically for atrial fibrillation. Really, as most procedures start, we try to use tools that we already have at our disposal, and that's exactly what happened in terms of ablation for atrial fibrillation. We use a standard catheter that was used for other arrhythmias, and that's a single point, we call it catheter, which basically at one point at a time, you go through treating the areas of the heart. And so I use the analogy, it's like a painter. So it's really like taking a small paintbrush, putting a dot of paint in one place, and using that to paint the room. And it really, we're doing that kind of a process. The current major advances are in terms of what we call balloon technology. And balloons are designed to actually sit around the structures called the pulmonary veins. And that is a site from which we feel atrial fibrillation commonly originates. And then by delivering energy through the balloon, we can then hope to block signals from coming out of the pulmonary veins. And so that's emerged as a standardized, well-accepted option in terms of treatment of patients as well. And so that's one other area. Now, there are other newer technologies that are also being developed to try to achieve more efficient delivery of energy, having the ability to deliver a series of lesions, areas of ablation at one time, rather than having to go point by point. Maybe we can use more of a roller kind of effect and paint a larger area at one point. So those are the kinds of things that are trying to be advanced in terms of atrial fibrillation ablation.